So today we are going to start. We'll see how to carve maxillary central incisor, permanent maxillary central incisor. So we have reduced this block roughly as per dimension, the mesiodistally and labiolingually. So you can see this is your natural extracted tooth, central incisor, and this is a wax block. So roughly we have reduced, so we can see it is elongated broader in this way. So this could be a mesiodistal dimension. We'll keep these two surfaces, mesial and distal, and the others would be labial and lingual. So the first step of any carving is division of the block. So all the four surfaces, divide all the four surfaces vertically into two halves. You have to draw straight lines in the middle of the surface vertically and join all these four lines on top on both the ends, so that you will get a cross or plus sign on top on both the ends. Now divide the block in three parts vertically, horizontally in three parts. So the first line, the first part would be the crown. The middle part should be a little longer for the root carving, and then base. So continue these lines on the other surfaces, so that all the four surfaces should be divided horizontally into three parts. So the middle part should be longer for the root, and other two parts would be for crown and the base. Now third part is labeling. After division of the block is the labeling of the block. So as I have already mentioned, the broader area, the broader part would be mesiodistal. So label one end, one surface as mesial, the opposite would be the distal. Okay, so you have to be very careful while labeling. So I am labeling this as M. M stands for mesial, and opposite would be distal. Opposite would be distal. Okay, so this is mesial and distal. The opposite, the other, the remaining parts would be, remaining surfaces would be labial and lingual. So for labial, L, I'm writing it as L. The opposite for anteriors, we can write P for palatal. P for palatal. So now let's start with the labial surface. Okay, so the labeling will be done on the base. So this part would be the base. Now start your crown part, the other end of the cover, the block. Now on the labial surface, when you are doing the labial surface should face upwards and hold the block like this horizontally. Okay, and hold the crown part between your thumb and the index finger. Okay, so the next part for the crown part is division of the block in the crown area. Now see, this is the vertical length of the crown. Divide the entire vertical length of the crown into three equal parts. So this would be the cervical 1/3, then middle 1/3, and the incisor 1/3. So there are three divisions on the labial surface. So same division you have to do on the other surfaces also. So continue this lines on all the surfaces, so that entire length of the crown would be divided into three equal halves on all the surfaces. Now check for labial surface again. Labial should be on top. Hold the crown part of the wax block between your finger. Now as you know, the labial surface is convex mesiodistally as well as cervico-incisally, but the 2/3 of the crown is inclined incisally, and the crown is convex. The height of contour is present at the cervical end of the crown. So let's reduce start the reduction of incisal two-third area. We are not going to touch the cervical one-third. Okay, so upper two-third we are going to reduce. So how to reduce this upper two-third? So place your straight end of the cover on the on this margin of the labial surface, the border, okay, at an angle, okay, and start moving from thumb to index finger through and through. Okay, so place your cover, the straight end of the cover, like this at an angulation, and then start moving like this mesiodistally, so that you are reducing entire upper two-third of the crown, and reduce at the upper end till you reach the center line of the block. Okay, so all these lines which we have drawn are very, very important, because some or the other important part of the crown would fall on this line. Okay, so now you can make out we have reduced till central line and we have reduced upper two-third of the block. We have not touched the cervical part. Okay, so now when you are doing this part, you might get concave surface on the labial surface. So if you get this type of surface, then you need to reduce at both the ends. So again, you have to place the straight end of the cover on both the sides and slightly reduce back at both the borders, so that the crown is convex mesiodistally also. Okay, so now we can see that our crown, if you see from top, the crown is convex mesiodistally as well as cervicoincisally. Okay, so you can see from this aspect also, we have reduced the upper two-third and we have not touched the cervical one-third. Now let's start the opposite surface, that is lingual surface. We'll start with the lingual surface, this side opposite. So again, in this area, on this surface, we are not going to touch this lower one-third, but we are going to reduce upper two-third, but not in a straight way, but in a concave way. So for this, we need to use this convex portion of the cutting edge of the cover, okay, same like this. Okay, so if we are using convex portion, it will automatically create the concavity, okay, like this. So we are going to move like this. Okay, so again you have to place this convex end of the cover on the edge. This is palatal, P for palatal, and start moving. So in few seconds your lingual surface is done, and you need to reduce till you reach the central line on top. Okay, so start reducing till you reach the center line. Your incisal edge should not become very thin. Okay, it should not become very thin. So now you can make out the lingual surface has become concave. The lingual surface has become concave. Now, so roughly labial and lingual surface is done. Now we'll move towards the proximal surface. So as we see in our natural tooth, the mesiodistally the crown is constricted. The crown is constricted. So we need to reduce at both the ends in the cervical area. Okay. So now place this mesial surface on top, hold it in between the fingers, thumb and index finger, and with the help of straight end of the cover, the tip of the cover should be on the cervical line, and reduce the cervical one-third. Reduce the cervical one-third, but your cover axis should be at an angle, because you have to reduce the cervical area. So it should be at an angle, not straight. If you keep it straight, the entire surface will go away. So you need to reduce only the cervical. So place it at an angle and reduce cervical one-third. Okay, so entire cervical one-third reduce as per dimension. So you can make out this is cervical constriction. Okay, similar constriction will give on the distal surface. Now see the opposite surface, distal. Okay, and again similarly, see your tip of the cover and the straight end should touch the cervical line, place at an angle and reduce. Move mesodistally from one finger to other, through and through. Okay, from one border to the other border. So that cervical constriction is done. Okay. The crown is a little more wider at the cervical, at the incisor edge. You can reduce a little bit crown from both the sides. Okay, so roughly your labial surface is done. So incisal dimension and cervical dimension labially. Now lingually we can see that cingulum is convex and it is much converging and constricted. Okay, but here the cingulum is not proper. So what we'll do, we'll merge both the proximal surface towards the center. Now we have, this is palatal surface. Okay, so now this is the cingulum area. So from one proximal end, again your tip of the cover and the straight end of the cover, start from the center of the proximal surface and go towards the center. Same thing from the opposite surface, from the center of the proximal surface towards the cingulum. So you have to move like this and like this, okay, till you reach the center. So like this, reduce the proximal surface. Like this. Similarly, the opposite side. Reduce. Now, after getting the cingulum convergence, reduce below the convexity so that your cingulum is more prominently seen. So, again, with the straight end of the cover, reduce below the cingulum. Below the cingulum. So now we can make out the cingulum part is done. Similarly, the labial surface.